It's just a little, it's a bookmark. It's just a little souvenir of the office here. Well, congratulations on being chosen, and I can see why you were.
Best wishes to you.
Thank you.
Senator, why don't we get a photo of the three of you here real quick?
Sure. Why don't you get the
picture? I'll take it.
Thank you.
Good. Mr. President, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, let's be in touch and get the details nailed
right.
down, okay?
Well, Mr. President, Marie Fisher.
Yes. Mrs. Fisher. Oh, yeah. So good to see you. Good to see you. We're back to 1980.
Todd Dominick, Mr. President.
And if you see that we'd like to get a picture of us. Well, it's good to see you.
Thank you. This is
I just have a little souvenirs here. Reading the system, CEO of the office.
Thank you very much.
It's a
stick thing.
Gentlemen, tie bars.
Thank you. Appreciate it, Mr.
Well, it's wonderful to have the opportunity to see you again. Oh, just fine. Yeah, she's deserted me for the day. She's up in New York. She's making a speech there tonight on drugs. She's a ginnam.
Yeah, and it's hopefully everybody. Beautiful grounds here.
Beautiful.
It's such an honor.
It's an honor that you come.
And thank you for accepting our letter. Especially,
I wondered if you did that.
Far. Yeah, we were kind of wondering if it get this far.
Well, I was pleased.
That's certainly are pleased too. Quite an honor.
She can't get over the maroon stain.
Oh.
As soon as she saw the uniform, she started to cry.
I was down to Paris Island just last week.
Mm-hmm. That's where they were at.
There's Marines down there. Mm-hmm. What a great bunch of young men they are.
Swirled.
Well, I don't want to have to move on. You
I know you're, yeah, sure, please, you take your hat off. It's such an honor to.
Well, I'm
not. I'll carry this thing I make. God bless you.
Well, bless you. I certainly
you got
will.
Me crying. Okay.
General, Mrs. Gabriel.
Hello there.
Good evening, Mr. Helms. Staff of the Air Force, Mr. President.
How are you?
Good sponsor.
Well, good to see you, although not too happy about maybe saying goodbye.
We're very happy about it. 36 years has been wonderful. Only the last four I'll never forget, thanks to you.
When you were playing for Red Lake, what position did you play?
Quarterback and defensive half. I was behind Arnold Gallifer, who was All-American, but so I was mostly playing defensive half then. But well, we never lost to Navy, and we had a couple of national champions.
Not too shabby.
And we've got some national champions. We've got some national champions in the last 4 years too. They've done a magnificent
job. Well, yeah, we almost had the Air Force, as you know, national champions this past year.
252 missions.
Well,
makes
that was
a lead in airplanes.
Those are good airplanes. P-51.
Here in between this and get a that's your picture and get a photo here.
Thank you. It's very nice to see you.
Well, it's good to see you.
Thanks for everything, sir.
They do.
Thanks. Sure. The defense is the strongest we've ever had.
Well, thank you for all the.
Thanks for the note. Sir, thank you for the note you gave us, the video. The gathering of eagles and Jimmy Doodle and everybody was gathered. That really came up big.
Oh, good.
Thank you again.
Well, yes, just a couple of souvenirs. Oh. That's a bookmark.
Thank you very much.
You read a book.
I have to. I'm glad to do that. Do you
like that? Thanks again, sir. Very good way.
Thank you.
Good
help. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Hello there.
Mr. President.
Very nice. Mr. President, thank you very much.
Thank you for all the help and all of our battles here in these years of the same time.
Well, you've been a super commander in chief. You've given us new life and spirit. Our sailors love you. And I couldn't have had a more fantastic 4 years. But you gave us the opportunity, Mr. President. Without any question.
You're very kind. I appreciate it. Why don't you get in the middle here and be a prettier picture?
Thank you. Yeah. Well, it's been wonderful.
Well, I wish
we've had a wonderful 4 years, and it's because of you.
Thank
my
you.
Husband says that publicly all the time, and he says it privately to me.
I believe
so. It's the truth.
Well, just 1 second. Just a couple. You're going to have to read a book, because that's a bookmark. Seal
oh,
as a souvenir.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. A souvenir for you and again, thank you very much for all the help. You can count on us now. We're very self-confident. You can be self-confident about us.
All right.
Taking you to do it. Thank you.
All right.
God bless you, Mr. President.
I don't know whether I should tell you, maybe I have already. But one day when I was talking to the lieutenant commander from the Coast Guard, Vivian, she's the first Coast Guard person and first woman ever to be a military leader in the White House. And I guess I was talking too effusively about Navy after one of our meetings or something, and very quietly she informed me that the Coast Guard is the unit around which the Navy gathers in times of
emergency. I love it. The great line.
That's terrific.
You selected a good woman.
Well, they've done a wonderful job, and I'm a conservative. I hate to see anything change, but apparently the rules are that things have to change. So we'll hope that they'll all continue to go as nicely as it has. It's been really wonderful.
Thanks
Thank
so
guys.
Much.
God bless you. Best of luck to you, sir.
Same to you.
Thanks, sir.
Here's this Baltic delegation,
yes.
Dr. Valaitis from Chicago.
I'm representing the American Baltic Committee.
Pleased to see you.
Mr. Parasil?
All right, sir. Nice to see you. You used to be my governor for 8 years.
What?
I am a Californian.
Ah, well. Well, those were happy days, too.
Yes.
Mr. Blinstrabus from Chicago.
How do you do?
Thank you.
Pleased to do it.
Mr. Pavlovskis from Maryland.
My name is sir. I'd like to express our support for the Copernic policy. There's something I'm going to follow.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mr. Gitchis from Philadelphia.
Hello there.
Thank you. Mr. Stevenson from New Jersey. Mr. Lambert from Boston.
Mr.
President, we're at the American so safe and with you all the way. Everything.
Thank you.
I want you to know that. Thank you so much.
Senator Regal.
Hi,
Mr. President.
Hi.
Nice to see you today.
Nice to see you.
It's Congressman Carney.
Hi. Mr. President, good to see you again.
How are you doing?
Good to see you.
Good to see you. Mm-hmm. Well. I want you to know that I feel very strongly about our continued meetings with the Soviets. We will continue to express our feeling, and there will be no official visits on our part to the countries that did not have a chance to decide whether they want to be the Soviet Union or not.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
And
And I'm most appreciative because I know that you are supportive of our efforts to keep another country free in Central America. There.
Mr. President, Dr. Politis would like to present you this award.
And before I do that, I wanted to talk a couple of minutes about a letter which we have prepared for you. And the letter primarily concerns this just one very important issue, freedom and democracy. I would like to really express our support of your activities in Central America. At the same time, we would like you to bring this issue of freedom and democracy and also the occupational forces to be removed from the Baltic states when you meet at the summit meeting with Secretary Gorbachev, and also, if possible, at the United Nations and also at the Vienna follow-up conference of the European Committee for Security. And I really would appreciate. We have summarized those things here, and we would like to give it to you, this letter. But at the same time, we've asked to come the presidents, we here, of the three organizations, and we'd like to hand it to you, this award. We'd like to read it for you. We really do appreciate very much your efforts in signing this very important proclamation of the freedom day for the Baltic states. And let me read this for you, Mr. President. Joint Baltic American National Committee presents Baltic Freedom Award to President Ronald Reagan in recognition of President Ronald Reagan's commitment to the aspirations for national freedom and self-determination of the people of occupied Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania, and especially for his continued support of Baltic Freedom Day. The Joint Baltic American National Committee, on behalf of the Baltic American, wishes to thank the President for his accurate description of the evil empire and for his continued disapproval and non-recognition of the illegal incorporation of Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania by the Union of the Soviet Socialist Republics. Thank you very much for everything you have done.
Thank you.
Can we pose for that photograph here? Why don't we pose?
Okay. Yeah. Oh, come
here, Rob. Yeah. Okay. There we are. Yeah.
And Mr. Lambert, please. Okay. Okay. Yeah, behind, and I think we can do all
well. I thank you very much, and I shall continue on being that we have the willingness to express ourselves on this. And as I say, I most appreciate that. Because you've taken our support of Central America. Back when your countries were taken over, the freedom fighters there in the West let it happen. I'm determined that at least this nation of the West will not behave in that way in the future. So right now, our opportunity is in Latin America, and they're going all out.
May I just bring up one more? For any reason that any Baltic person should be deported to Soviet Union, we feel that that would be not very appropriate.
Mr. President, also, if I may, I've given you this twice before. This is the third time I've given you this. You must have a draw for giving to you in free and independent Latvia.
I wish nothing better than that would happen. Thank you.
Thank you,
much.
Sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Feel this way.
Feel
thank you.
Regarding the turnover in Lithuania, Latvians believe the major power plants and they're of the same type as Chernobyl. And as you know, the country, the three republics are fairly small and they're concerned for the population. We're hoping that the International Commission could inspect those plants and so at least the people will be safe.
I was greatly encouraged when Gorbachev expressed his willingness desire to have an international thing now that can do that. And we should keep that very much in mind. Yes.
Thank you very much.
They've also apparently just learned that they're taking Latvians at night to go and clean up the Chernobyl plant. I mean, they're taking them out under cover darkness without any protective gear. to clean up this plant. They've just found this out in the last couple of days. But I mean, it's a real problem. Anyway, it's great honor to see you here.
Thank you.
Well, I finally solved the problem of what to do with you when you retire, Mr. President.
What to do with me when I retire?
Yeah, I've got a job for you. Oh. I've been reading Thornton Wilder again. And I was struck by the way he describes in Our Town the soliloquies of the stage manager. The similarities between the prose and the descriptions you give of Dixon, Illinois, when you were a kid in your book. And the idea came to me, this would be a dandy part for Ronald Reagan when he leaves the White House. In a revival of Our Town in LA, Chuck Histon could direct. Did you ever see that play?
No, I never did see the stage play.
Oh, that's a fabulous play. It's about life at the turn of the century, between 1904 and 1914, in Grover's Corners, New Hampshire, which is an imaginary town. It's about life and marriage and death. It's a very philosophical, sweet play. And the whole thing is organized, held together by a stage manager, who just comes on and talks and introduces the characters. If you don't know the part, you don't know what I mean. But I'm going to talk to Chuck Histon about that.
I don't know whether I could go back to that business.
I've fully recovered, I guess, right now. We're going to go to the next round. And the thing I just want to take a moment of your time on today is that I don't know if you can believe it, but South Dakota is under water. I guess it's about the most.
Washington.
Yeah, you can do some of it. We have probably the most rainfall we've ever had in at least 150 years. And in this particular part of the state, the farmland is under water, and they just simply can't take advantage of the farm program. In order to qualify for the program, this important thing called deficiency payments, you have to plant your crop. Now, you can plant your crop and get flooded out. You plant your crop and dry out, and you can collect your deficiency. And these people who signed up for the program, who received 40% advance payment on their deficiency, we went out and bought the seed, fertilized it, made all the plants, and still waiting and trying to crop. And look, I'm my head, Bill, that I've been serving in a certain number of appropriations, and simply say that if these people signed up, burned square, made all these extra expenditures, just because they couldn't get the plant properly, they would qualify for the 40% difference, no more. The thing I want to leave you in mind is that they do have a form of crop insurance now called preventative planting. Put it in for the first time. My people have 2 days to learn. And they've never got the story. They didn't have insurance. And that's going to be...
Well, I've had a chance to certainly at least give a kind of a solid once over to the recommendations of the commission, and I think we ought to support them on it.
Yes, indeed.
And I know we've got some horrendous problems of morale and so forth with those good people at NASA. So I also have a letter for you. And you hear about it, I would kind of like to have a follow-up, maybe some kind of regular scorekeeping on how we're coming.
Sounds very appropriate. Well, Mr. President, I think you did the right thing by setting up the Rogers Commission. It's a pretty comprehensive report, as you know, but the recommendations are sound. We support all of the recommendations. Some of them can be already started, and we're going down that path. Some of them are going to take longer, motivation of people and the reorganization and so forth. That has to be looked at very carefully. But be assured that your goals and concerns are our goals and concerns, and we want to get NASA back on track again, and we will do so.
It was too great a record of success to have a lingering feeling now that know, that has changed. I can understand the morale, but I think the people had such pride in it, and justly so, because it was a great record of success.
Mr. President.
Close to Monticello.
Oh.
I don't put the place there, but other things, it's too far to be taking the patients so far.
They are in dying condition, and we are not enough available to them. So I would ask you to get us help.